Hey everybody, today I'm gonna run Ymir Strikes and just to show off what I'm using to do it. First off, let me say by no means is this an ideal setup. This is just showing what I'm using to do it. And you know, you really don't have to have a top tier healer like Urd. Baldur works just fine as long as you have the right equipment. Let's look at some gear here. First off, on Luca, I have the Winged Helmet, the Sacrifice Shield, the Choco Shield, whatever, and some Crystal Armor, along with a Purity Ring, which is basically just health and magic defense. That's really all I want it for. Luca's Ring, which I don't know if this resists stacks or not, but you can't get these anymore. But it has decent stats on it. An arcane ring for more magic defense up, and then the ring of Niflung again for the HP and the magic defense. That's really what I'm concerned with on this one, is magic defense. Then we've got a Scald set up with the Celestial Helmet, which I'm using that mainly for the attack 25% up for 2 turns, which then makes the Asgard Blade and the Valkyrie Blade stronger, which is what I use to Crystal Crush. And then a Winged Helmet, which is basically just for the health regeneration, which looks like I haven't even bothered to do anything with it yet. And next we have Gull with Sleipnir's Kinect Battle Weapon, because it's light based, that packs a punch in its magic defense, a magic attack up for 2 turns, which then I use for the Key of the Asgard, which again is for Crystal Crushing. And then the Lotus Flower is just because it does a decent amount of damage in it and makes the skill gauge go up. And then a Straw Hat for some healing and just, you know, some basic, again, magic defense up and HP is really what I'm concerned with. And then, you know, this is just for the buff magic attack. And we got Baldur, which I just tried to make him as tanky as possible. So we've got a healing popsicle here, and a glacial cloak, a guardian turban, and the druid's cloak, along with the Bangle of Faith, some mystic earrings, an arcane ring, and the guard dog ring is basically just for the stats. And then Chun-Li, which is fairly good in this fight. And again, I have a bulldozer, the light bow is for Crystal Crushing, a straw hat, and then her costume, and the star pendant is the only thing really different in this one. And that rounds out about who I'm using right now. Again, like I say, this is by no means a the best team to do this with, and it's not the best gear either. It's just it's working for me, so I'm running with it. And we'll do one here. And this is also on solo. Let's turn auto off. And really the key for me in this fight is just to get rid of the crystals as soon as possible. Turn on auto until at least the limit burst is about to come where I can use it. Switch auto back off. Scald's Limit Break, Sacred Trinity, which is basically just goodbye crystals. Let everybody use their abilities. There we go. And as you can see, once you get rid of the crystals, he really is not much to deal with. I mean, he hits pretty hard, but as long as you can survive the attack, he's not that bad. Turn auto off, because there's no point in using the skills when if it's at the end of the life bar. I should get the Sacred Trinity right here real quick to help break these crystals down. I don't want the limit burst to auto use it on the end of a health bar. That's wasteful. Go ahead and use it again, because this is one of the best limit breaks. This and Odin's are the best two to use. Awaken Odin's. I don't have Odin, so I use what I have. I think the only one that I have that's hard to get that you can't get anymore is Chun-Li, but the rest of the characters that I'm using, Lucha, you can get her in the Soul Trader. Everybody gets Skull. Baldur's easy to get on the summon, and so is Gulvig, so none of it's really that hard to get, except for Chun-Li. So you don't need, like, a super elite team to be able to do this. The main thing that I worry about is crystal crushing, and then once that's done, he really goes down pretty quick if you focus him with light water attacks. And there he goes. And got one soul, 85 tokens, and let's look at the damage here. MVP, of course, is Skull. That's really the only one that matters for me. It's just the fact of keeping her alive so she can keep doing light attacks, and that he goes down pretty quickly. And that's with the free character that you get at the beginning of the game, so he's really not that hard to do. And that's it for this video. Thank you for watching, and have a good day.